This video is made possible by the partners and supporters of ICZC Ministry.
This is the second thing that I feel is so needed. Why? Because there is so much misunderstanding about it. And that is this. There is a difference, and I feel even in my heart so much that the Lord says this is true. It's true because it's in the Bible, but many people have been reading the Bible with their own spectacles of interpretation. It's so easy for all of us. And what is this? It's the difference between the time of the reign of the beast or the Antichrist and the day of the wrath of the Lamb of God. When I say this, I already feel, poor Lord, He was the Lamb that was slain before the foundation of the earth. And John the Baptist says, behold the Lamb of God that does away the sins of the world. He came to love and to bring us back to where we were in paradise, in total communion and fellowship with His Father. As He said when He left us, I go up to my Father and your Father. We are sons and daughters of God. And Paul says, what love the Lord has given you, Gentiles, and everyone that believes in Him, Jew or Gentile, that you should be called, not Baptist, not charismatics, but sons of the God of Israel. And I know that I'm an eternal son of God. God loves me and you so much that He does not want to be separated from you for eternity. He wants you to be around Him. Is that unbelievable? That He gave us the same title as His own Son and the same extension of life. He who believes in me, Jesus said, will never die. And there's so much emphasis in Christianity about now. I want now to be married, now to be blessed, now to be wealthy. The best thing you can do is to trust the Lord. He may bless you here. I'm not saying. But this is the gospel, that He so loved you that He gave His only begotten Son. Not that we would have a nice Christian life here, but that we would receive back what we lost in paradise, to be eternal sons and daughters of God. And why do I say this? Because all this changes. When I read it, I said, the day of the wrath of the Lamb of God, that Lamb that was so full of love and gave His blood, now is going to come and trample the nations in the winepress of His wrath. And Isaiah sees this come. Who is he who comes from Bosra with his garments stained with blood? And we all say, oh, Jesus is coming, Jesus is coming. But I see it more and more clearly. He's coming through the valley and tramples down the nations that have come against His beloved Israel. And He was alone. It says, no one was with me when I trod the nations out in the winepress of my wrath. It pains Him so much that He says, those who believe in me, don't look. Go into your rooms. He is alone because He says, they could all have been saved. And there was no one with Him when He trod the nations in the winepress of His wrath. That is part of His coming. That's why the Bible calls it the terrible day of the Lord. And with all the sweet preaching, Jesus is coming down. Yes, but he's coming for a purified bride. And that's why the Lord needs the Antichrist and the beast to purify us. And the Bible tells us that we will be here on earth at the time of the reign of the beast. For the Bible says in Daniel and Revelation, the beast will fight with the saints, not some saints, the saints, and overcome them. And you see what is happening now in the churches, how people fall away, and how fewer and fewer remain faithful. And there where we have sinned, that we can say, Lord, I learned from my sin, forgive me, but help me to live. As the Bible says, he who is holy, let him be holier still. Help me to learn from my lesson and be there. As the Lord says, he who endures to the end will be saved. But there will be a great falling away, a great purification. There's not going to be a divided and ugly and corrupt bride waiting to be raptured. That is not in the scripture. The Lord comes for a bride that has made herself white in the blood of the Messiah. He comes for a white bride. In Rome, there will be the world church that doesn't need to repent. You can be a homosexual pastor or a homosexual priest, or you can do things which the Lord tells is wrong and not repent. That church is called a harlot. She's not white. So where are you going to be? Are you going to be with the Lord and allow the Lord to purify you by the events that are taking place? The corona is only one, but the Bible says there will be earthquakes and wars and rumors of wars and epidemies. It's only the beginning. We will be so shaken that, like Job, we will say, how can this happen to me? And the Lord allowed the devil, who got the permission from God to purify Job, so that at the end of that purification, which is symbolic of the 3.5 years of purification under the reign of the beast, that we all have to go through. And that's why we need to look at Job. Job was not saved out of it, but he remained so close to the Lord that he could say at the end of his test, like we will, I knew him from afar, but now I know him face to face. And the Lord blessed Job double at the end of his life. It's not that God doesn't want you to be blessed, but with great power and signs and wonders, the beast will come and deceive the whole world after he, with a deadly wound, has been miraculously healed. And he will put a statue and give life to the statue. Can you imagine? So, and all the world shall follow him. But he will be nice to those who put, not an injection, as everybody speaks about the injection. The Bible doesn't speak about an injection. The Bible speaks about a sign of the beast, either on your forehead or here. And if you will not, he will be after you. Now listen, the beast will be nice to the people that worship him and choose for him by putting their sign. In other words, the false kingdom of the beast will have a person that demands submission to him, as the true kingdom of God, as a person, the Son of God, that says, if you do not forsake all that you have, you cannot be my disciple. So there are two. We will be raptured, or we will go to the Lord before the day of the wrath, because the Lord does not come to tread us out. That's what very, very few Christians understand. We will go to the Lord before he comes to tread down the nations that come against his people Israel and the church, or and the believers. But we will have to go through the reign of the beast that will fight with the saints and overcome them and cause many to leave because they didn't hear this message. And they will not know, like Job, why is he doing this to me? And God did not explain himself, he just waited. Will he be faithful through all this trial of his faith? Like Jesus said to Peter, and he says it now to you. Peter, the devil has wanted to sift you as the wheat, but I have prayed for you that your faith fail you not. That we keep on believing, even if everything seems to be dark. And the Bible says, if the Lord would not shorten these 3.5 years of Job trial to the church in the end time, no flesh would be saved. So strengthen yourself. Know that the Lord is with you. Job says, I cursed the day that I was born. He couldn't understand. He says, I've lived for you. How many Christians get this message? When things will not be easy. And you remember this word, says, I'm going to go the way of Job. What did he say? Though he slay me, yet shall I trust him. So there are two. The day of the wrath, it will be very short. The day of the wrath of the Lamb, before which we will be going to him. And the time of reign of the beast to purify us, to be his bride. May you be part of that.